Folks, we're all really familiar with our little dispenser bottles, which are the answer to a maiden's prayer for putting colour exactly where we want it on our fabrics. And in those, I am using my favourite 1/4 concentrate, 3/4 water. But we don't always want to be working with little bits of fabric. We sometimes want to do the meterage. We want to get into big bits. So we're going to talk about maxi dispenser bottles. I'm going to show you how to mix those up and how to use them, because they are a little bit different from the little fellows, a little bit less controlled. And then we're going to talk about spray painting, but let's do the maxis first. Okay, Liquid Radiance is a very pure product. It doesn't have a lot of chemicals in it. It doesn't have stuff in it that will kill off bacterial action that you can get from using tank water or town water. So my preference when I'm using a lot of water with McCulla is to actually buy bottled water and use that, because presumably that is bacteria free. When I want to mix up my colours into the maxi bottles that we've got here, we're just going to drink a bit. Enough to fit some colour in. And I'm going to make up a yellow based colour because they're a bit tricky. I'm going to put about a half a bottle of concentrate into my 250ml bottle minus a couple of mouthfuls. When you're mixing your colours, always start with your lightest colour in your mixing vessel or bottle or whatever first, and then add your darker one to it a little bit at a time. And the more different they are in colour intensity, the less of one of the darker you have to have in proportion to the lighter one. Okay, we have orange. Let's check what's going on in here. Let's use the craft paper test. If I put a dollop of that onto the craft paper, mixing into yellow, you can see, is a little bit deceptive, because it is always lighter or more yellow on the fabric than it is in the bottle. So no matter what colour you're mixing, go for your craft paper test and you're always going to get the colour that you want. Now with the cap on, the hardest bit is to take off the bit so I can open my bottle. So we have our maxi bottles ready for use. With storage, you can still get a little bit of bacterial action into these bottles. And if we have a look at this one, you can see there's some gucky bits in there. So just like on our little bottles, I've put a piece of stocking over the top, and I know that anything that has accumulated in there, because this one has been stored for months, will be strained away before it goes onto my fabric. The same is going to happen when you're working with the bigger bottles, and we'll make one of those soon, but let's talk about it now. You can see, again, with storage, we have a ring of mold happening on there. The good news, the mold and the gucky bits do not put the product off. The product is fine. Here in the maxi bottles, all we're doing is straining it. With our bigger spray bottles, we're going to simply put that through a couple of layers of damp chucks and strain away all the yuck, put it into a clean bottle, and you're back in action with it. With our maxi dispenser bottles all ready and for action, we're going to now start applying colour to some big pieces of fabric. But before we do, I want you to have a look at this piece of fabric here, which was coloured using red and magenta. And I want you to start thinking about something I call an undertone. In the magenta section of this, you can see like a pink stain in the background where that doesn't happen under the red. Three of our colours leave that undertone. Magenta, purple, and blue are the main ones, and we'll do it almost reliably. And if you look at the shirt I'm wearing too, you can see that there's a pinkness in parts of this shirt that almost stand out and look a bit ugly. Well, I don't mind that. But if you don't want it, you don't use that combination of colour. Whereas if we look at this one here, which was orange, brown, and my favourite Irky Murky Dirty Green, which is the yellow-black mix, there is no undertone. So you can work your colours according to what you want, your colour choice, that is. On this fellow here, you can see that purple undertone at the base, but less of the undertone as we go up the bag. I also want you to have a look at the reverse of this bag in one spot, because you can see a funny little patch that actually has like a blotch on it. That blotch is because my board mustn't have been properly cleaned. And fortunately, that will pick off or brush off. I need a little bit more effort to get it off, but yes, if that happens to you, all is not lost. Just use a good firm brush or your fingernail and you should be able to peel it away. Look, it's really better to keep your boards clean, isn't it? Anyway, back to work. I'm going to pretend that this is a big piece of folded fabric. Unfortunately for this style of application of colour, you'll end up with stripes, but stripes are fine for your quilt backs or for any other fabric designing things you want to do. And I'm still trying to decide on colours here. Let's go Irky Murky Dirty Green. And you'll notice as I apply these colours, it's a bit different from using the little dispenser bottles, because this is going to go fast. Remembering that excess is your enemy. However, I am working through four thicknesses of calico. Make sure you leave good gaps. Aubergine, which is the equal red magenta mix. You'll see that one is Genesis Purple on the colour mixing guide. Got to also remember here that I've got hems at the sides of my bag, so I need a little bit of extra colour there. And also a hem at the top. Now this is the orange that I've just made, so there's no need to put the stocking on that as a strainer yet. With our normal five-finger foam brush, we would then work our hands across that. But I've got a much simpler method. Oh, no gloves, I'm over them. A bit of help on those edges. But not too much, we don't want to go into enemy territory. And without moving it around on my board too much, I'm simply going to work those colours through all the layers, because if I move it around on the board too much, I'm going to be picking up colour where I don't want it. Oh, if you're doing fabric, by the way, you won't have handles to tuck in, will you? Work those colours. We can add a little bit more if necessary, bearing that in mind. Yeah, two thickness of four layers of calico, that is two bags, are going to take a fair bit of colour. But they don't feel sloppy, so I know I haven't gone into enemy territory. And I have a bag ready to do something with. I might poke it into a bread crate. I might put plastic lace on it or a stencil on it and pop it out in the sun. Guys, you know all those bits and pieces. So I'm not actually going to do that now. I'm just going to put it somewhere and deal with it later and move on to something else exciting. Let's take it we didn't want another one the same. Mush that all up. Blend those colours. These are fabulous in the microwave. It's feeling just a little bit drier than the other one. It was the underneath one. Let's throw something else in there and see what can happen. you're colouring your fabrics, you're in charge. You know that excess is the enemy. Well, I hope you do by now. You know that while there's moisture, there's movement. So things are going to keep happening while they're wet. If that was a bit sloppy, maybe I could blot that out with another bag and do a similar sort of random thing with that. Fabulous for your quilt backs. Use the colours of your quilt and see what you can come up with for your backgrounds. You can do your hills and valleys, you can salt it. You can do your heliography things, as I mentioned before. You can microwave it, you can poke it into a bread crate. Ah, you can draw on it with water-soluble resist. You can do whatever you want. I'm just going to scrunch that and lean on it and get our favourite air exclusion happening. And deal with the others later.